Company is making detectors to warn people about shootings in schools, airports, and other public locations. And their technology might soon be implemented right here in Massachusetts. Joining me this morning is Christian Connors. He's the CEO of Shooter Detection Systems. Thanks for being here this morning. I appreciate it. First of all, this has become such a critical issue, not only in public spaces, but in our schools where we're sending kids. Shootings are happening so often that people want something to offer some form of protection, and it sounds like you may have one component of the answer.
Well, we're trying to. We've worked with the military over the years to deploy over 10,000 military gunshot detection systems to Iraq and Afghanistan. So when we were able to basically take that capability that's been deployed for the military, now bring it into the school and public market.
Did you ever think that kind of technology would be applicable in an elementary school?
No, we certainly hoped it wouldn't be, but unfortunately it is, and we're trying to make a device that will assist in mitigating the threat.
So being in a war zone is, of course, very different than being in an elementary school or a middle school or high school. How does your technology work that it can differentiate between what is gunfire and what might just be a big noise?
Exactly. So we've had thousands of rounds fired downrange and done a lot of testing, including here in schools and with Methuen, Mass. We were able to conduct live fire tests. To confirm that the system wouldn't false alert. We believe one of the biggest issues is you have to detect, but you can't false alert and interrupt the school day. So, again, there's been over $30 million invested in this capability by the Defense Department and DARPA and the prime contractor that we bought it from. So, so far to date, we haven't had any false alerts, and we have over 99% detection rate.
So tell me how it works and then what the procedure is once it detects that shots have been fired.
Sure. We have two microphones in the system, and what the microphones do is listen for the sound of gunfire. Once that occurs, we have two infrared cameras that look for the muzzle flash of the weapon, and then from there we output that information, similar to what a smoke alarm does, to the local authorities and to the school personnel.
I know that you can't put any dollar amount on keeping your kids safe, and yet there are limited resources, especially in schools. So what's the price point for something like this, and how does a school district go about paying for it?
There's been over $25 million invested by the United States government, so we have a really low startup cost to be able to do this, number one. And the key to the company, we believe, is one, the false alert needs to be zero, capability needs to be 99% or better, but most important is the price point as well. So we looked at it, rough price point for the system is similar to putting in a security system of cameras.
All right. When it comes to developing all this, you actually had Navy SEALs who were working on the development of this.
Yes, they work with us. We're honored to be working with them. They've been a great asset to the company. One of them's here from Massachusetts. So not only developing the product, but implementing the procedures. So when an active shooting incident happens, we've been able to learn a lot from them of what people should do after that occurs and how we take our information and put it into the process of an active shooter incident response with the police and with the superintendent.
Tell us a little bit about, as much as you can, about the location here in Massachusetts where some of this will be implemented.
Sure, we were really appreciative. The city of Methuen has been extremely supportive. Chief Solomon and Judy Scanlon, the superintendent. So we've conducted many tests. We've actually had the system in the school to make sure it doesn't false alert. We made sure it was a benign system, so it wasn't threatening or interrupted the school day, and we're going to be outfitting one of their schools very shortly here, probably in August.
Very interesting. Where can people find out more?
Our website is www.shooterdetectionsystems.com.
All right, Christian Connors, thanks so much for joining us this
morning
and explaining to us a little bit about it. We appreciate it. Melissa, over to you.